Gloria a Dios. Gloria a Cristo que vive. Aleluya al Señor Jesús. Gloria al Cordero que vive. Santo es su nombre. Bendecido sea su nombre para siempre. Él es el Señor. Bendecido Dios. Estamos aquí, primeramente le damos gracias a Dios por un día más y gracias al Señor por sus bondades, gracias al Señor por sus maravillas, porque Dios es bueno y para siempre es su misericordia. Somos los hermanos de la iglesia Getsemaní, radicada en el 1938 de Daly Avenue. Nuestro pastor, el hermano Mike Durant, su esposa, la hermana Generosa, sus hijos Joan, Maida, Michael y Gianni, juntamente con su esposa Yocasta. Bendecido a Dios. Nuestra hermana Sunilda, bendecido a Dios. Y esta servidora, aleluya, dándole gracias a Dios e invitándote a que nos visites para que escuches palabras de vida eterna, porque el Señor te ama. Bendecido Dios, bendecido Dios para siempre. Bendecido sea el Señor Jesús. Vamos solamente a decir, a leer un texto de la Escritura. Solamente un texto, pero que abarca mucho. Bendecido Dios, porque nos habla del amor de Dios. Bendito Dios para siempre. Bendecido Dios. Aleluya. En el Evangelio, según San Juan, en el capítulo 3, el verso 16, Juan 3, 16, en el nombre del Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo, porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo que ha dado a su Hijo unigénito para que todo aquel que en él cree no se pierda, mas tenga la vida eterna. De tal manera amó Dios al mundo que ha dado a su único Hijo, su unigénito, para que todo aquel que en él cree no se pierda, mas tenga la vida eterna. A veces nos creemos y pensamos, el día que yo muera, pues no me preocupo, todos vamos para un mismo lugar. Hay gente que se mete eso en la cabeza. Pero tristemente, en el día postrero, unos resucitarán para condenación y otros para vida eterna. Y si tu nombre no se haya escrito en el libro de la vida, será lanzado al lago de fuego. Y si no hiciste una decisión por Jesucristo en tu vida, te vas a perder eternamente. Jesucristo es el camino, Jesucristo es la verdad y Él es la vida. Y no hay otro nombre dado a los hombres por el cual podamos ser salvos. Él es el único camino. Él es la verdad. Él es la vida. Para el Señor no hay casualidades de que te esté escuchando la palabra de Dios en esta tarde, porque no vas a tener excusa cuando esté allí delante de la presencia de Dios. No va a haber excusas. Nadie va a tener excusas, porque todos compareceremos delante de su presencia para darle cuentas a Dios. ¿Qué hicimos con nuestras vidas? ¿Qué hiciste? ¿Qué hiciste con el sacrificio de Cristo en la cruz del Calvario? Cuando te presentes delante de Dios, ¿qué hiciste? ¿Qué hiciste con esa palabra, con esos mensajes que has estado escuchando por mucho tiempo, por tantos años escuchando Cristo viene, por tantos años escuchando Cristo salva, por tantos años escuchando Jesús te ama, Jesús murió por ti en la cruz para darte vida, y tú por tanto tiempo has sido indiferente a la palabra de Dios? No has querido rendirte, no has querido dejar el mundo con su concupiscencia, no has querido humillarte delante de la divina presencia de Dios, pero no vas a tener excusa. Jesucristo te ama, murió en la cruz, derramó su sangre, en Él no había pecado, en Él no había mancha, en Él no había arruga. Santo, porque Cristo eres santo, porque de tal manera amó Dios al mundo que envió a su único Hijo, a Jesucristo, para que todo aquel que en Él cree no se pierda, mas tenga la vida eterna. Él tuvo una naturaleza humana, como hombre sintió sed, como hombre le daba sueño, como hombre se cansaba. La diferencia es que en Él no había mancha y en Él no había arruga, porque era el Hijo de Dios que vino a morir por ti, a derramar su sangre por ti, por amor, porque no hay amor como el de Dios. Quizá el amor de tu esposa, quizá el amor de tu madre, quizá el amor de tu hermano, quizá el amor de tu amigo, pero nada, nada se puede comparar al amor de Dios. El amor de Dios es sufrido, el amor de Dios es benigno, el amor de Dios no cambia. Cristo es el mismo por la eternidad. Quizá esa persona que tú amas tanto, en quien tienes tanta confianza, un día te defrauda y te maravilla y dice, pero ¿por qué fulano me dijo esta palabra? ¿O por qué fulano me hizo sentir mal? Pero el amor de Dios no es así. El amor de Dios es un amor puro, es un amor tierno, un amor sincero. Jesucristo te ama tanto, te ama tanto que dio su vida por ti en la cruz, te ama tanto que derramó su sangre preciosa, te ama tanto que llevó tu pecado en su cuerpo, siendo santo. En Él no había mancha, no había arruga, mas sin embargo no escatimó el morir por ti en la cruz del Calvario, porque Él no quiere que tú te pierdas. Él no quiere que ninguna alma se pierda. Vienen días terribles. Vienen días terribles. Bendecido Dios. Días terribles. Estamos viviendo principios de dolores, porque las cosas no están como empezaron. Las cosas no están como empezaron. Hay señales de su venida. Hay señales de que Cristo viene. Ya hay señales de que Cristo viene. Bendecido Dios. Ya la venida de Cristo se acerca. La Biblia dice que cuando digan paz, la Biblia dice que cuando digan seguridad, vendrá destrucción repentina. Jesucristo viene. Jesucristo viene. Y no quiere que tú te pierdas. Él no quiere que ninguna alma se pierda, sino que todas procedan al arrepentimiento. Escapa por tu vida. Escapa. Ya está bueno para buscar agua en cisternas rotas. En el mundo, dice la Biblia, lo que hay es aflicción. En el mundo lo que hay es aflicción. Cristo es el único que nos puede salvar. Dios te bendiga, mi hermana. Amén, gloria a Dios. Aleluya, gloria a Dios. Bendecido Dios para siempre. Aleluya. Amén. Gloria a Dios. Gloria a Cristo. Escapa por tu vida, como le dijo el ángel a Lot. Escapa por tu vida, no mires tras ti. No mires tras ti. Mira a Cristo. Mira a Cristo, que fue el que pagó en la cruz. El que dio su sangre. El que dio su vida para salvarte. Medita y piensa dónde estás parado. Medita dónde vas a pasar la eternidad. Jesucristo te ama. Jesucristo te ama. Ven a Jesucristo. Ven a Cristo. Él pagó el precio en la cruz del Calvario. Él pagó el precio. Él pagó el ticket para que tú puedas entrar a la eternidad. Él murió por ti. Naciste en pecado. Heredaste la naturaleza pecaminosa de Adán y Eva. Eres pecador. Necesitas a Cristo. Necesitas a Jesucristo en tu vida. Lo necesitas. Para Dios no hay casualidades. Bendecido su nombre para siempre. Bendecido el nombre de Jesús. Él vino a buscar y a salvar lo que se había perdido. Medita dónde vas a pasar la eternidad. Jesucristo compró el ticket. Lo pagó en la cruz del Calvario. Él es el camino. Él es la vida. Bendecido Dios. Bendecido sea tu nombre. Aleluya. Gloria a Dios. Hay caminos que al hombre le parecen derechos. A lo mejor tú crees que te estás viviendo muy bien. Oh, lo estás pasando muy bien. Tiene tu buen trabajo. Oh, eso es bueno. Muy bendecido. Todo te va bien. Todo te ha ido bien. Aleluya. Pero medita. ¿Y cómo está tu relación con Dios? ¿Cómo está tu relación con Dios? Medita en eso. ¿Cómo estás tú? ¿Cómo te sientes? ¿Dónde vas a pasar la eternidad? Y si la muerte te sorprende, ¿dónde vas a pasar la eternidad? Déjame decirte, si vas sin fe, sin Cristo y sin esperanza, hay caminos que al hombre le parecen derecho, pero su fin es muerte. Quizá tú te crees que estás muy bien, o todo está muy bien, pero ¿y dónde tienes, qué lugar le has dado a Cristo en tu vida? ¿Qué lugar le has dado a Dios en tu vida? Medita eso. ¿Estarás preparado para la eternidad? ¿Estarás preparado para la eternidad? ¿Está tu nombre escrito en el libro de la vida? ¿Lo has recibido como Salvador? ¿Lo has recibido como dueño? ¿Lo has recibido como amo de tu vida? ¿Lo has recibido como el único que te puede perdonar tus pecados? Medita. Medita, porque tienes un alma linda que salvar. Tú eres especial tesoro para el Señor. Medita. ¿Cuántos mensajes has escuchado? ¿Cuántas palabras de Dios? A lo mejor tienes tú una Biblia. ¿Pero dónde vas a pasar la eternidad? ¿Te has arrepentido de corazón? has recibido a Cristo, te dejo con esta palabra: eres especial tesoro para el Señor. Jesucristo te ama y no hay casualidades para el Señor. Vamos a tener ahora a la hermana Zunilda con nosotros. Aleluya. Y está atento a la palabra de Dios. Dios te bendiga.
Gloria a Dios. Glory to Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Jesus, for this beautiful afternoon that we have today. We thank you, Lord, for every person that is passing by. We thank you, Lord Jesus, for every ear that is listening. Not just hearing, but listening. We thank you, Lord. We worship you, Lord Jesus. We give you praise every time. We give you praise, Lord. Hallelujah. My name is Zunilda Vargas, evangelist of the Lord, for his mercy. Thank you, Jesus. We will bless the Lord all the times. His praises should continually be in my mouth. My soul should make its mouth in the Lord. The trembler should hear, and he will be glad. Oh, magnificent, the Lord with me. And let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he hear me, and delivered me from all of my fears. He looked at him. They looked at him and were radiant, and their faces were not ashamed. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. When we look upon the Lord and claim his name, not from the mouth out, he'll come to us. He'll come and live with us, and our appearance will change. Just like the Psalm 34 says, when you seek the Lord, your face will be radiant. Because you're seeking the Lord. You're not seeking the things of this world. And therefore, it's going to manifest within you. God bless you. There was one time when Moses spent 40 days and 40 nights on the mountain seeking the Lord. And when he came down the mountain, his people, they were afraid of him because his face was radiant. And that's because the glory of God was upon him, was with him, because he sought the Lord for 40 days and 40 nights. And that's what happens to each one of us when we seek the Lord. We don't look the same. We don't stay the same. Because now you are acting the way God has guided you in the secret place. And many people might say, but what is God? I see God. Well, just look at nation. Look at nature. Look at the wonders of the world. They didn't just come out of nowhere. God spoke and it happened. Everything that is made, God spoke and it came to pass. No man made any of these wonders of the world. You've seen it. You see the History Channel. I love it. Discovery Channel. Because you learn a lot of these things that are nature of God. So nature recognizes the majesties of God. And here we are, the most beautiful creation of the Lord, which is humankind. And we cannot even recognize the Lord. We recognize our own self. I'm this, I'm that. Oh, I know this one. Oh, I know the president. Do you know God? Because the president, human, not going to take you anywhere. They might take you to things that are going to finish. But God will take you to eternal life, where he's going to serve you dinner, a table, or in front of your enemies, the Bible says. So stop doubting that God exists. He is a spirit. That's why you cannot see him, because we need to seek in spirit in truth, not by your flesh, thinking that your prayers are going to be answered just because you ask. You got to ask within your heart and believing that God is true. And believing when you ask, it's going to happen, not doubting. Oh, maybe. I sure hope so. Well, let me tell you, if you say any of these things, nothing is going to happen to you. Because you're going to be positive in the things you say. You're going to first come to the Lord and receive Him in your heart. And know that He's real. And start seeking Him in spirit and truth so you could see His glory. Hallelujah. Another occasion in the book of Exodus, Moses was decided to free God's people out of bondage. And he did all that. But the people rebelled against God so bad that God said, I'm going to destroy them. And this is why so many people say, oh, what about God? What kind of God is going to come and destroy His own people? Disobedient. The Bible says, what father that loves his children will not discipline them? Because he loves you, he will discipline you. Not kill you, not to harm you. Discipline is very different from maltreatment and hatred. But he disciplined. And that's exactly what he did. So for Moses, plead for these people. He prayed to the Lord because Moses had a relationship of you and I. That's the relationship he had with the Lord. He spoke to him face to face, and you can do the same thing when you seek him in spirit and truth. God is real. You don't know these things because you haven't committed yourself and say, I am tired of this world. I am tired of serving this evil people here. I'm tired of being slave or Satan telling me what to do in this world. I'm going to follow the Lord, the one who created me, the one who knows me from before the foundation of the world. So Moses prayed for these people to God so he won't destroy them. And then he told them later on, God, if I have pleased you, if you consider me your friend, show me your glory. Hallelujah. This man, just like you and me, Moses, he was chosen to set God's people free by the glory of God, led by God, not the evil one, by God. He spoke to him face to face. And then he asked them because he knew how to ask and what to ask for. Because when you ask for things that is for your own good, things that are for wicked, let me tell you, nothing is going to come. Because you're just asking for wicked things to get revenge, to get at your neighbor, at your brother and sister. Don't even pray that kind of prayer, because it won't come true. And if you do, it will be an evil one, because the devil is involved. And there will be no forgiveness for that kind of talk or prayer to the devil. So the Bible says that when he asked him to show him his glory, God wanted to do that. God wants to show his glory to you. God wants to show his glory to you. But you must seek him. You must humble your heart and surrender yourself to the Lord. You don't believe because you have not seen the Lord. And you don't need to see to believe. Just know that he's there because he's a spirit. God is real, people. God is real. He wants to bless you. He wants to walk with you just the way he walked with David, the way he walked with Elijah, the way he walked with Moses, the way he protected his people. The Bible says at night he walked with them with a column of fire to warm them up and give them light. And during the day, in the desert, sunshine, I'm pretty sure over 100 degrees, he covered them with his cloud. Hallelujah. What an amazing God we serve. Your Creator is waiting on you to come and knock on his door. It's being open. Now it's up to you to receive it in your heart. God is good. God is good, people. And you might say all the time, but all the time. No. Let me tell you, come and experience it, and you will really will say that with joy. Because you say God is good all the time just because you hear it. Just like atheists, they say, oh, Jesus. They don't even know about Jesus, but they claim to Jesus because they hear it. Lord, my God. Thank you, Jesus. You're an amazing God. A humble heart he will never reject. Seek him in spirit and truth, and you'll find him. So continue with Moses. So God told Moses, meet me in this place. Meet me in this place so I could show you my glory. But I will have to cover your face because no man can see my face and be alive. But I will cover your face. I'm going to pass by. And when I pass in front of you, I am going to remove my hand so you could see me. Hallelujah. The Bible says that when God passed through Moses, God removed his hands from Moses' face, and Moses was able to see God's back. Glory to God. What an amazing encounter. See him face to face. God is real, and he is ready to reveal himself to you. As long you let him, as long you open up your heart to him, open up your heart to the Lord. This is not forever. This is not forever, people. God is real. You have the Spirit of God in you. When we die, that Spirit is going to go back to God. And your soul is the one that remains forever to choose from here where you're going to spend that eternal life. Are you going to be in a place of torment? Or are you going to be in a place where there's no more pain and no more sorrow, which is heaven? Hallelujah. And many people might say, oh, I pray. I pray. Then again, you pray for your own flesh. I want. I wish this person will go, and wishing the worst to your neighbors, to your family, to your brother and sister. That's not a praying to God. That's praying to the devil. You don't know God. If you die from here, you don't have Jesus, you won't be in eternal torment. That's not purgatory. The Bible said there will be a place where you're going to be waiting. With the gritting of the teeth and the maggot will never die. There will be a torment on you. That's the first death. Because you're waiting to be judged. In the judgment day, the Bible says, in the book of Revelation, chapter 20, from 13 on, it says, on that day, you're going to be standing in front of white throne, which is the throne of God. You're talking about, like, oh, let God judge me. Yeah, the judgment. You don't even know anything about the judgment day. Read the Bible and you find out about it. It says everyone is going to be standing in the throne of God to be judged. Little and big, old and young, standing in the throne of God. And you're going to be judged for whatever you're doing, good and bad. And then it says, and those who were not found doing anything good for God, they're going to be thrown in a lake of fire. That's what the Bible says, the book of Revelation. Look for it. Know the truth, and the truth will set you free. You cannot mock people at God. You cannot mock God. You cannot. My God, Jesus. The Bible says that during that time, his people, which is the Jewish, the Israelite, God, they saw all the miracles that God did on them. Get them out of Egypt, departed the Red Sea. They saw all this. They were fed from bread of heaven. And they were still revealing against God. God called them stiff necks. Stiff necks. Doing whatever they wanted. Oh, la vida loca. Let's live today because tomorrow we're going to die. Let's drink tonight. Today is Friday. Hoy se bebe. Reprenda el diablo. Let's seek the Lord every day, just the way you eat, just the way you bathe yourself, if you bathe yourself, the way you brush your teeth, if you brush your teeth, you gotta look for God every day, throughout the day. Not just go and say, oh, repetitive prayer that you will give and you will little book. I had that book. Repetition. God doesn't want that. God doesn't want tradition. God doesn't want sacrifice. He wants obedience. Seek the Lord. Seek the Lord so you can be free and know the truth. Just the way that I learned it. I didn't know any of these things. I thought I knew it all. I knew it all. Nobody's going to tell me what to dress, how, what to do, what to drink, who to go out with. I was the baddest. For walking men, because when I used to get dressed, the shorter one, I got my six pack, my high heels, provoking. And then you think about, oh, they molested me, they framed me in the park in the corner. Well, how are you dressed? You're provoking. It takes two. If you cover yourself, if you're not out there in the corner looking for to be seen, nothing will happen to you. Seek the Lord. Seek the Lord. And you'll have the peace that you're looking for, the love that you're aiming for. Because this is what we look for. We're in the street looking for love, for happiness, peace, contentment for each other. But acting and doing whatever you want, you will not find it. Seek the Lord. Seek the Lord. I pray to God. I know too. I knew it. In the book Isaiah 59. And don't think when I talk about reading your name in the book of life, oh yeah, my name is Joseph, my name is in the book of life. No, it's not like that. It's a prayer that you have to say, Lord, forgive my sins and write my name in the book of life. I believe in you that you are the Son of God, that you rose in the third day, and only like that you will be saved and your name will be written in the book of life when you ask. Not because it's in the Bible, because my name is Joseph, it's in the Bible. Oh yeah, my name is in the book of life. I had that done before. No, it's not like that. You need to ask the Lord to write your name in the book of life. In the book of Isaiah, it says, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, behold, the Lord's hand is not shortened, that cannot say. No, his ear heavy, they cannot hear. But your iniquities have separated you from your God, and your sins have hidden his face from you, so that he will not hear. For your hands are defiled with blood, and your fingers with iniquity, your lips with spoken lies, your tongue has flutter perseverity. No one calls for justice, nor does any live for truth. Thy truth is empty words and speak lies. They consider evil and bring forth iniquity. They hatch vipers' eggs and wave a spider web. He who eats their eggs dies. And from that which is crushed, a viper breaks out.
Santo. Hallelujah.
The Lord is ready for you to cling to his name. He's ready to hear. His ear are not heavy to listen to you when you come in spirit and truth. He is ready to forgive you and to embrace you. His arm. His arms are wide open for you. He is not a man to lie or a man to not keep his promises. Jesus loves you, sir. He loves you. Keep sick and you're fine. Find him.
Santo.
The Bible says that in it's Isaiah 40:31. For those who wait upon the Lord should renew the strength. They should mount up and wings like eagles. They should run and not be weary. They should walk and not faint.
Let's look upon the Lord, not up to your own thing, your own will. I want. God doesn't work like that. Surrender yourself to the Lord and you'll see his wonder working in your life and your family. Stop looking for revenge. It doesn't work like that. God's revenge, not yours.
Stop acting like evil ones. Stop making the evil one happy. Just know, you know what's good, you know what's bad. Choose the right thing to do. Choose right. Choose life. And the book of Malachi 3:5 says, and I will come near you for judgment. I will be a swift witness against sorcerers, against adulterers, against persecutors, against those who exploit wages, earth, and widows. For I am the Lord, I do not change. There are not consumed.
Santo.
We change. We change. We don't want to serve the Lord. We want to serve ourselves. I want to do this. I'm going to do that. You change. God has never changed. He never fails. He has never changed. He's always the same forever. He will never change. He is the same forever, and he will reign forever. No matter what you say, what you do, God is real. He is merciful, and he's waiting on you. He's waiting on you. And Malachi 4:2 says, but to you, shall rise with healings of his wings, and you should go out and grow fat like a stall-fed calves. You should trample the wicked, for they should be ash under the soles of your feet. On one day that I do this, says the Lord of hosts.
Hallelujah. One day everything's going to be ashed. That's what the Lord just said.
But the son who are his, those who are his know his voice, and he knows them too. That's the beauty of it. So no matter whatever you are, if you are a son of the Lord God, he knows you, and you will know his voice too. Everything is going to turn to ash on that day. The Lord of hosts has spoken. God bless you all. Those who want prayer, want to accept the Lord Jesus, at this time we are here still. Our church is around the corner, 1938 Daly Avenue. We miss you. God bless you, and come and get your prayer. God bless all.